Hello everyone, welcome to Curious Plus, and today we'll talk about black holes. Black holes are the supermassive objects in our universe which bend the fabric of space-time around them. They bend it so much that not even light can escape it. Their gravitational pull is extremely powerful. So where do these black holes come from? These black holes are usually created when a massive star dies in a supernova explosion. When the star reaches the final phase of its life, it reaches the final phase means the fusion process in its core comes to an end. It does not burn any more hydrogen. It does not produce any more energy. Then we know that the final stage of the star has come. Scientists believe that we can find a supermassive black hole at the center of each large galaxy. The supermassive black hole at the center of our own galaxy is called Sagittarius A. Its name is Sagittarius A. Its mass is around 4 million times more than the mass of the Sun. So it is extremely heavy. We call this a black hole because nothing can escape from it, not even light. We cannot see it directly. If light comes out from an object, then we see it. So the gravitational pull of the black hole is so powerful that not even light has the speed or escape velocity to escape the gravitational pull of a black hole. That's why we call it a black hole, because it looks dark. We cannot detect it by its visuals, its looks. We can only know it only by the gravitational influence it exerts on the nearby astronomical objects. Black holes can be created in two ways. Actually, you can define two types of black holes, or we can categorize two types of black holes on the process in which they are created. The first type of black holes are the supermassive black holes. These black holes are found at the center of each large galaxy. And the second type of black holes are the stellar mass black holes or stellar black holes. These are created when a star dies in a supernova explosion. So how were these supermassive black holes created? Actually, these supermassive black holes were created at the initial stages of the universe. When matter was created in the Big Bang, it became, it grouped onto one another. It eventually grew to such a mass that it collapsed under its own gravity. That's when the supermassive black holes were created, or they were born. Okay, the supermassive black hole at the center of our own galaxy, as well as the supermassive black holes at the center of other galaxies, were created in that process. They were created at the initial stages, at the beginning of our universe. That's why they are such massive objects, such supermassive objects. Then there are another type of black holes. These are called stellar black holes. So these stellar black holes are created when a star dies in a supernova explosion. And you have to know that not every star becomes a black hole. For a star to become a black hole, its mass should exceed at least 20 times the mass of a sun. So if the mass of a star is more than 20 times the mass of a sun, then it has a great possibility that it will become a black hole after its death. These are not as heavy as the supermassive black holes, but their mass grow eventually with time. So when a star dies in a supernova explosion, its core collapses under its own gravity. Okay, and eventually the collapsed core becomes to accumulate a mass around it. It begins to accumulate mass from the nearby astronomical objects, and eventually its mass grows, and this can become a massive black hole, but not as massive as the supermassive black holes. As of now, we don't have much data on black holes, but as far as we know, there are two main parts of a black hole. One is called its singularity, and the other is called its event horizon. So what is the singularity and what is the event horizon? The singularity of a black hole is the place within it. It is actually located at the center of the black hole. Actually, it is the black hole. Okay, so the singularity of a black hole is the place within it where the density of matter is infinite, or it is extremely small. It is infinitely small. So what we mean by infinitely small, because we don't know. simply stated, we don't know, because everything we know, everything, every mathematics, every physical theory we know breaks at singularity. Okay, we can't calculate the size of the singularity or anything about it using the present theories and mathematics. Now, what is the event horizon of that black hole? The event horizon of that black hole is the space around it from where nothing can escape. It is the place of no return. Not even light can escape it. That's the event horizon of a black hole. So let me illustrate that to you with an example. Okay. Here, let's say you throw a stone upwards to the sky. You know that after going some distance, it will fall down, because we know that the gravity of the earth pulls it, or the space is curved here, so the stones falls. Okay, the stone falls, we know that. But we also know that if we could throw the stone with a certain velocity, then it will escape the gravitational pull of the earth, and that velocity is 11.2 kilometer per second for the earth. If you throw is stored with a velocity of 11.2 kilometer per second, then it will escape the gravitational pull of the earth. That's how we launch rockets, that's how we launch the satellites using this concept, the escape velocity. We know that we can escape the gravitational pull of the earth. But for a moment, imagine that you are at the event horizon of a black hole. So we know that the gravity or the gravitational pull of the black hole is so extremely powerful that nothing can escape it. So we can define the event horizon of the black hole as the place from which the escape velocity needed for an object to escape from its pull is more than the speed of light. It is the speed limit of the universe. We know that the speed of light is the maximum or the highest in the universe. It is around 300,000 kilometers per second. Nothing can exceed that speed limit. So the event horizon is the place around a black hole from which the escape velocity required is more than the speed limit, or the more than 300,000 kilometer per second, which is not possible theoretically. So what is the importance of black holes in physics and the future of physics and astronomy? You see, the study of black holes holds the greatest potential for a physicist, because it can unravel the deepest secrets of the universe that we don't understand as of now. We can think of black holes as the place where we have to push ourselves beyond the boundary of our, you know, knowledge, because they exceed, they are at a place where we can't reach them, we can't solve them, we can't understand them using the current knowledge, the current physics, and the current mathematics. Everything breaks. So why are you studying black holes? Why do we need to study black holes? You see, these black holes pose a great challenge for us. They ask questions, or we have to ask questions that need a higher mathematics, something that we don't know as of yet. Okay, they lie beyond the realm of our current understanding of the universe, and if we are to solve black holes, then we have to combine the theory of relativity and the theory of quantum mechanics. So the solution of black holes, or the complete understanding of black holes, will open up a new gateway to the universe, to the secrets of the universe. That's why black holes are important for us. I like how the physicist Leonard Susskind puts it. Black holes are the place at which the clash of principles happen. This clash is between the principle of quantum mechanics and the principle of relativity. Okay, and so far we have been unable to combine these two theories, or combine these two principles, to produce a coherent theory of the nature of the universe. So if we are to study black holes, then we have to do it, and it is the next step in our evolution as a species. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions related to this topic, then be sure to drop that into the comment section, and I'll make sure to answer that. So thanks for watching. Have a nice day.